Welcome to BuySpares. This video will show you how to replace the motor in a VAC 6131 multifunction vacuum cleaner. Before replacing a part in any electrical appliance, you must ensure that the appliance is first unplugged from the mains. If you use your VAC's multifunction as a wet vacuum, make sure it's completely dry before starting. In order to access the motor, you need to unscrew the handle from the top. But to do this requires removal of the data sticker, so make a note of everything on it for future reference. Start by lifting the head unit off the cleaner and unscrewing the two screws holding the handle cover on. Next, unscrew the cable grip at the side and make a note or take a photo of how the cable is connected to the terminal blocks for reference later, before unscrewing and removing it. Remove the switches from the handle by using a flathead screwdriver to squeeze the locking barbs on the side of the switches and pulling them upwards and out. You then need to undo the two bolts on either side of the handle to separate the top from the rest of the head unit before lifting the top off. Remove the motor cover by unscrewing this screw at the side. Next, make a note or take a photo of the connections to the motor for reference before disconnecting the cables by pulling the spade clip itself and not the cable. Otherwise, you may separate the cable from the clip. Undo the three bolts around the cowl in order to separate it from the motor base. The two parts are still connected by the hose from the pump and can't be separated completely, so just place the cowl next to the base. Make sure you transfer both rubber seals from the old motor to the new motor, as this isn't supplied with them. Then place the new motor into the base, making sure you align it the same way as the old one, before placing the cowl back onto the base. You can use the flat lip on the front to help with aligning the two parts. Connect the cables to the motor using the photo or notes made previously, and reattach the three bolts around the cowl. Screw the motor cover back on, then put the cover of the head unit on and feed the two switches up through the sides of the handle. Click the switches into place on the handle, then screw the cable back into the terminal blocks using your reference notes or photo, and reattach the cable grip. Finally, screw the two parts of the handle back on. For all the spares you need, visit www.buyspares.co.uk.